when you look at the history of warning lead times in the National Weather Service, you can point to events and where you see a sort of a bump in the graph where we've improved. The first one was the implementation of Doppler radar in the National Weather Service. You even see a bump from the first VORTEX experiment. The information and knowledge was disseminated to the operational community from there. NOAA and the National Weather Service has a goal of increasing tornado warning lead times to approximately 20 minutes by the end of this coming decade. And so we want to, VORTEX2 is a necessary component. We need to, in order to get the warning lead times up, we're going to have to improve our knowledge. In order to get better knowledge and better scientific understanding, that's what VORTEX2 is about. And hopefully the results from that experiment will end up leading towards that goal. We're doing a VORTEX2 now because we think that our technologies for mobile instrumentation and for putting observations from the field into models has gotten to the point where it warrants spending the money and the effort to do this. In the first VORTEX program, we had one mobile radar for 1 year. Now we have 10 or 12 mobile radars for 2 years. In the first VORTEX, we had just a few cars doing surface observations. Now we have 30 or 40 surface observation instruments that we're able to deploy. So the advances in computer technology and communications technology, all those things we think we can do our job a lot better than we did back 15 years ago. The other half of that is that we now know how to take this data and do something much more useful with it, because we know how to assimilate the data into our computer models, which means actually taking the data and instead of just sort of comparing it to a computer model, actually taking the data and putting it inside the computer model and sort of creating sort of a virtual representation of the storm we saw in the field. And from that, we can really do a lot of different, we can really test a lot of ideas out and see how it evolves over and over. The biggest challenge for VORTEX2 is probably just moving a large number of vehicles which have instrumentation on them and finding the right storm and the right road network and the right sort of situation. For example, storm, in order for us really to collect data very well, we're going to need a fairly slow moving storm, something along the 20 to 25 miles per hour. If it's moving very fast, we're just sort of line up in front of it and sort of let it overrun us. But with a slower storm, we actually can try to sort of chase it with the instrumentation. That takes luck. I mean, there's no question there's an element of luck in all of this, but it also takes just the ability for us to sort of efficiently communicate with each other and coordinate with each other to make it all happen.